Leukoderma, vitiligo, white patch disease. The very name strikes fear, sometimes terror, in the minds of patients. They get scared. What is this vitiligo? That is what we are discussing today. Dr. Venkatram Mysore, consultant dermatologist, Venkat Center for Skin, ENT and Plastic Surgery, Bangalore. Vitiligo is a disease which causes white patches. Leukoderma is the common man's term. In Kannada, it is called tonno. It occurs on the face, the lips, hands, feet, chest, genitals, any part of the body can be affected. Why people are so afraid? That is because, one, they think there is no treatment. Two, they think it is hereditary. Three, they think it is contagious. Four, in Sanskrit it is called Shweta Kushta. Kushta means leprosy. So there is a lurking fear, doubt, that it is related to leprosy. And as you know, leprosy in the olden days, there was a lot of stigma. Now leprosy is completely treatable. It is eliminated from India. So there is no need to be afraid of that. The facts are like this. One, vitiligo is a harmless condition. It does not cause any problems except the change in color. Two, it is hereditary only in 30% of patients. In 30%, it is like any other disease. Three, it is not contagious. Four, it is not related to leprosy. Five, it is treatable in nearly 70% of patients. Please understand this. Remove the fear from your minds. Do not be afraid. Treatment is different. Fear is different. Take treatment, but don't be afraid. Now, what are the treatments available? And why is this disease occurring? This disease is what is called autoimmune disorder. You must have heard the word immunity in the light of COVID. Everywhere immunity, immunity is low, immunity is low. Here the problem is not of low immunity, it is altered immunity. Meaning, the body develops immunity against its own tissues, starts developing antibodies to its own cells called melanocytes, which are the pigment producing cells. These antibodies then destroy the cells, resulting in lack of color, so the skin becomes white. In our brown-black skin, the white color stands out. In the white skin, Caucasian skin in Europe and elsewhere, it is hardly visible, so they don't take it seriously at all. In fact, in many countries in Europe, if a white man goes to a dermatologist with this problem, the doctor just explains it, tells him not to worry, and that's the end of the story. The problem is in the brown and black skin because the white patches stand out. And of course, in our country particularly, there is a social stigma. Stigma to such an extent that the person finds it difficult to marry, his sister or brother finds it difficult to marry, entire family suffers. This is most unfortunate, nothing more sad than this particular aspect. It is a harmless condition. A man or a woman can marry, they can lead a normal life. Please understand this. What are the treatments? Basically, there are three approaches. One, medicines, creams, tablets. Two, machines called phototherapy, ultraviolet light therapy of different types. Three, grafting or surgery. Medicines, we give vitamins, we give topical steroid creams, we give certain growth factors for melanocytes, melanocyte growth factors. We give a drug called tacrolimus to alter the immunity. Then orally, we again give vitamins. Sometimes to control the spread of the disease, we give steroid tablets in what is called a weekly pulse steroid, once a week or twice a week. That is a very safe form of treatment. Then we give capsules called oxorolin, trisorolin, which is a plant product. This is a herbal medicine obtained from certain plants. It is also found in Ayurveda. You take the tablets and 2 hours later you stand in the sunlight to expose the body, what is called puasal therapy. Then we have machines, phototherapy machines. These machines deliver ultraviolet light, which is beneficial for skin. Ultraviolet light A and ultraviolet light B, what is called narrow band ultraviolet light, that when it falls on the white patches stimulates the melanocytes to produce color. You need between 20 to 40 sessions, 50 sessions. The treatment is safe. You need to come 2 to 3 times a week. This is particularly useful for women when they have lesions on the body where they cannot show it to sunlight. It's a very safe and comfortable treatment. Sometimes we also use a laser called excimer laser or targeted phototherapy, which focuses only on that lesion, particularly useful in children. We also have a machine which focuses on hands and feet. So these are the different types of machines. There is also one machine which a patient can buy it and use it at home called home phototherapy. Sometimes in nearly 20-30% of patients, there may not be improvement with these medicines and the machine. Then we do grafting. We take a small piece of skin from somewhere, usually in the thigh and the buttocks, then put it on the area. In one method, which is very popular now, called cell suspension method, we take a tiny piece of skin, then we can make a suspension. There is a laboratory process to do this. A liquid is prepared and that is spread over 10 times the area that you have taken. So if you take 1 square centimeter skin, you can use it for 10 square centimeter. It's a simple outpatient surgery under local anesthesia and patient goes home the same day. Result take 4 to 8 weeks. This is called epidermal cell suspension method. New methods include melanocyte culture methods that still are not useful everywhere. It is not available everywhere. So these are the treatments which are available, and with these modalities we can effectively control and treat in a majority of patients. If it is so, if we can treat it well, why is it people are afraid of? That is because there are some old-time patients who have extensive disease all over the body who cannot be treated now. It's very difficult to treat them. Looking at them, people think this is not curable because they keep on walking around in the society. But most recent patients are treated very effectively and they are leading a normal life. Now there are some new drugs which are in the offing called biologics, JAK inhibitors. There are also some creams to hide the lesion. Supposing you want to go to a marriage, some you want to go to a function, you can put that cream so that nobody notices it. So different options are available. There is no need to be afraid of this disease. We all need to work together to get rid of the stigma, the fear that is associated with this disease, and educate the society, educate the patients, and also treat them well so that they all can lead a normal life. So remember, vitiligo can be treated. Thank you. If you want to know more about any skin condition, any dermatological treatment, cosmetic treatment, hair treatment, please visit and subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you want to seek a consultation, please contact the telephone numbers that will appear on the screen shortly. Thank you.